naturally believe about God. These particular belief systems must be already inside by default. So when you come across them in life, you will feel like there's contact, that you agree with them. But in essence, the only thing that we have in our default system is that the ultimate creator is one. And he cannot possibly become part of his creation, and his creation cannot be part of him, and nothing shares his attributes, because all of us are deficient, and he has the ultimate names and qualities with the ultimate meanings, which no human being or any of the creation can ever reach, because of the concept of the designer and the design, the manufacturer and the product, and the creator and the creation. They cannot bring one another. They cannot be used interchangeably. So, looking into some of the biblical and the Quranic texts pertaining to this understanding that Jesus is the Son of God. Islamically, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaches us in Surah Al-Imran, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وإذ قالت الملائكة يا مريم إن الله اصطفاك وطهرك واصطفاك على نساء العالمين. And remember when the angel said, O Mary, verily Allah has chosen you and purified you and chosen you again over the woman of mankind. She was honorable in the sight of Allah. She was beloved to Allah. She was a pious woman, better than thousands of men who have come upon this earth. This particular woman, Mary, peace be upon her. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues to tell us the event. Allah says, ذَلِكَ يَا مَرْيَمُ اقْنُطِي إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ وَاسْجُدِي وَارْكَعِي مَعَ الرَّاكِعِينَ. O Mary, be devoutly obedient to your Lord, and prostrate and bow with those who bow. After Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned these particular incidents, the statement that occurred in the past, which the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam could have not possibly had any information about that. Because this was something that was not common among the tribe of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because it was basically a combination of pagan Arabs who worshipped idols, who had no religion. You know, they claimed to be followers of Abraham, but they were not the people of the book. They were not among the people of the book, so there were no scriptures being distributed around. There was no bookstore where the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam would go buy a Bible and then read this information and say, okay, let me come with my own version of that. So this is something that is historically understood. So the people would not have a confusion. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala supported the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam by saying, ذلك من أنباء الغيب نوحيه إليك ما كنت لديهم إذ يلقون أقلامهم أيهم يكفل مريم وما كنت لديهم إذ يختصمون. Allah says, interpretation of the meaning in English, this is from the news of the unseen which we reveal to you, O Muhammad. You were not among them when they cast their pens to see who will take responsibility of Mary. Because when her mother decided to devote her daughter to the worship, to the house of worship, the place of worship, they started disputing who will take responsibility of her. So they would throw their pens in a lake, and whoever's pen will rise to the surface will be the one that's like drawing lots, as they say, will be the one who wins. Who was it? Zakaria, alayhi salatu wasalam, is the one who wound up taking responsibility of Mary. And Allah said, and you were not among them while they disputed. While they disputed who would be responsible of her. Then the next verse says, وَإِذْ قَالَتِ الْمَلَائِكَةُ يَا مَرْيَمُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُبَشِّرُكِ بِكَلِمَةٍ مِّنْ إِسْمُهُ الْمَسِيحِ عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمُ وَجِيهًا فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ وَمِنَ الْمُقَرَّبِينَ. And remember when the angel said, O Mary, verily Allah gives you glad tidings of a word from Him. Now this is very significant because in the Christian context they have another understanding of this word. What this word means is be. The word from Allah is that Allah Azza wa Jalla said, kun fayakun, be will deal with inshallah later on in the lecture. So the angels gave a glad tidings of a word from Allah, which will be the Messiah. His name will be the Messiah, Jesus, the son of Mary. The interesting part is that he was called in the Quran often and often and often, Isa ibn Maryam, Isa ibn Maryam, Jesus, the son of Mary. Although it is known among the Arabs and otherwise that you are always referred to the name of your father. You say Ahmed bin Abdullah. And what have you? You always refer to the father because this is what is common among the people. So he did not have a father. That's why he was called Isa ibn Maryam. Isa, the son of Mary. رضي الله عنها وعليه الصلاة والسلام. طيب. So his name will be the Messiah, Jesus, the son of Mary. He will be held in honor in this world and in the hereafter, and he will be among those who are close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيُكَلِّمُ النَّاسَ فِي الْمَهْدِ وَكَهْلًا وَمِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. And he will speak to the people in the cradle as a young infant and at maturity, at old age, and he will be among the righteous. Now, what would Maryam do? The angels came with the news. Then the actual thing materialized when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Jibreel, Gabriel, to Mary. فَتَمَثَّلَ لَهَا بَشَرًا سَوِيًّا. So he came to her in the form of a proportioned man, a man in good appearance. She said, إِنِّي أَعُوذُ بِالرَّحْمَنِ مِنْكَ إِن كُنْتَ تَقِيًّا. Verily I seek refuge in the most merciful from you if you truly fear Allah. Now this, I want you to imagine what kind of piety this sister was upon. She had taken already a screen away from her people. She was already in seclusion. And Jibreel came in the form of a man, a handsome man. And she did not know he was an angel at that particular point. The first thing that she said was, I seek refuge in Allah from you. Because he may harm her, huh? He may seduce her. She may, you know, وَالْعِلَذُ بِاللَّهِ as some women may do, be fall into some sort of fitna, and a long story. But because of her iman, and the strength of her iman, the first thing she did, she sought refuge in Allah. Leave me alone. Well, don't harm me. قَالَ إِنَّمَا أَنَا رَسُولُ رَبِّكَ. No. Don't be afraid, in other words, the meaning of the verse without the actual wording. Verily, I am only the messenger of your Lord. لِأَهَبَ لَكِ غُلَامًا زَكِيًّا. To give you the gift of a pure boy, which was Jesus, peace be upon him. Then he blew into her sleeve, and then she became pregnant by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is where the Muslims and the Christians agree, which is known as the Immaculate Conception, the Miraculous Conception, which is Jesus being inserted, in a sense, through a spirit from Jibreel into the womb of his mother without the interference or the assistance or the need of any human being. No man was a father. It is a source of trial. It is confusing to some, the fact that he did not have a father. To them, and it came from Allah, from God, a word from him, then they say that it must be God. That God must be the father. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refuted that in the Quran by making things very simple. إِنَّ مَثَلَ عِيسَى عِنْدَ اللَّهِ كَمَثَلِ آدَمَ خَلَقَهُ مِنْ تُرَابٍ ثُمَّ قَالَ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ. Verily, the similitude or the example of Jesus in the sight of Allah, Isa, is like that of Adam. He created him from dust, then he said to him, be, and he was. So anyone who has this misunderstanding, we can always refer them to an example which they know. Say, listen, who was the father of Adam? Say, no one. Good. Who was the mother of Adam? Say, no one. So then Adam is better than Jesus. Adam is better than Jesus. If you bring this chair, if two people worked on it, that's one thing. If one person worked on it,